much.
Good morning, YouTube. This is WackMed19, bringing you another gameplay with commentary. This time we have Mr. Irish Rebel again with his FAD doing a little Moab action during a clan op. The True Killer is taking on the world, getting some gold, and he's going to help us out so much with all of his kills and throwing down a Moab in a team deathmatch action, which is so incredibly hard. I mean, there's only 75 kills to be had. And to split that up among six people, he takes over 25 of them, even has a death at the beginning of the match here, and still gets more than enough kills for his Moab, calls it in, and everybody leaves, which is incredibly annoying. But kudos to him for the Moab. Everybody wants one. Not everybody can get one. And he just happens to have one, pulls it out of his pocket, and calls it in. Not only does he call in the Moab, he calls in several killstreaks along the way. And because we're playing hardcore, we're running a lot of UAVs. We're also running ballistic vests. It gives you that little extra edge. One more bullet in a lot of cases, where it takes the enemy to knock you down and keep you down. And we'll see a couple of times during this gameplay how that actually works to Irish's advantage and saves his life. He earns so many sets of ballistic vests and throws them down. True team player. How nice of him. Of course, he always takes one for himself as well. Because, I mean, why else would you carry them unless you were going to have them for yourself as well? Ballistic vests really are that underrated kill streak that a lot of people don't run and really should. It's right at the bottom. It's easy to go with the UAV and not selecting a third kill streak. It makes it so potent. There's UAVs and ballistic vests throughout this entire match, and those two combinations in hardcore really are underdone. It aggravates the enemy team so much. How many times have you been pissed off because you go to kill the guy and that last bullet that you didn't put into him because you count it and you don't want to spend extra bullets is the one that doesn't put him down because of the vest, and then you wind up getting taken down in place of him? It sucks so bad. You don't want to run into that. And why not run that on the enemy team? Carry that around. Make them mad. It's just, it's there to be used. Please do it. It's such a great tip. There are so many players that do it. I mean, this guy gets a Moab, and that's what he's running. Whereas most of your Moabs, people are looking for a specialist kill streak. They want to have that little advantage over the enemy team. The ballistic vest is a huge advantage over the enemy team. It makes you one more bullet than all of the other guys on the field. Really, really something that people should look into running more often. You should try it. Let me start seeing some more of those ballistic vests on people that I'm playing against. Irish is posted up now. He's not going to go very far from this spot. He's already got several kills. He's got some vests out. People are coming by to pick him up, and he's just going to sit here in the middle of the map, watch him spawn over his shoulder right there to the left, and take down enemy after enemy. For some reason, they just keep coming through there. They don't wall bang him out, which is my standard tactic. They don't do enough flashes. They don't get any grenades on target that are going to take him down. The cars are already destroyed, which is a key thing to happen whenever you're in this place. You do not want those cars there to cause you a problem later on. And they're going to keep coming out through the gate that's in front of him there and trying to make it through that side, and it's just not working out. But on the other side of the map, our guys are set up. They're not coming through the house. They're not coming up the stairs. They can try that B-side alley, but he's going to take out most of them as they come through that way. And it's just not going to work for them. He runs out of his vest because he gets shot. He puts on another vest, pulls out his UAV. He's running low on bullets in his FAD, or so he thinks. He hasn't been counting, and he can't tell. He actually makes the comment in this gameplay that he hates not knowing how many bullets he has in his gun. And that's true. A lot of core players rely on that to know when to reload. Nice kill through the car window, through the wall window door thing there. That's just so great. He has on a fresh ballistic vest, and he's earned more. And all he has is his sidearm. So it's really going to be more of a challenge now. He throws out his other ballistic vests for his friends, and it's definitely a helpful thing for us. Got another one coming around the gate right here, and somebody's got his back. We're not really looking for the Moab. We're not trying for the Moab. He has not called out that he's getting close to getting his Moab. It's just something that kind of happens, and it takes us all by surprise whenever he winds up calling it in. Because, I mean, I've been on other teams where people announce, oh, I'm fixing to get my Moab, I'm 5 kills away, or whatever, but he really doesn't do that. In fact, he's actually going offensive here, looking for those other kills. He didn't have to come around the corner looking for the guy. He could have waited for him. He didn't have to go into the kitchen looking for that kill. And he's really racking up right here at this point in time. Still continuing to throw down those ballistic vests for all of us. And even now, he should be running low on his sidearm bullets, and for some reason he doesn't pick up anybody else's gun, which is kind of bizarre to me. I'd be picking up, switching out, looking for more bullets, make sure that I'm still potent. I don't know what he was thinking there, but it works out for him. He gets his Moab, and that right there is why you have to have ballistic vest. He'd have been dead. There would have been no Moab. It would have been a Moab fail, and that would have just been so aggravating. But good for him. He gets it, calls it in, and everything gets blurry. Doesn't that stink? And we start to see everyone leave the game. How annoying for everyone to just drop out because they just got... I mean, the damage has already been done. Little handshake there by Smoke Eater, which is hilarious considering Smoke Eater is the one that came over and shook his hand. The rest of the gameplay is going to be sped up to super speed because everybody's gone except one guy. He gets killed another time or two. And to add all insult to injury, Irish is even the one that gets that kill. There we go. There's nothing else to do here. They forfeit out. We don't even get to finish the match, and we're so close anyway. But it happens. Another TK clan op for the win. Count it. And as the gameplay wraps up, if you would go ahead and click on that like button for enjoying the Moab, or go ahead and let Irish know how much he should not camp in one place. The two annotations on the screen will take you to other videos. One is a clan battle in which the true killers take out low on sugar, and the other one is more Irish playing hardcore kill confirmed on Piazza, where he does much more running. Thanks, y'all have a great day.